A lot of times around here, I give DIY skincare a really hard time, but today we're trying a DIY vitamin C serum that is PhD chemist approved. This is me, I'm so royal. Hello and welcome to the Queendom. I'm Sarah Engel, and today we're trying Lab Muffin Beauty Sciences DIY vitamin C serum. Vitamin C serums can be extremely expensive. One of the most popular ones is from SkinCeuticals, and I think it's around $166. It's in like a little container like this big. Usually I'm extraordinarily opposed to DIY skincare because it's usually a load of garbage and you're way better off buying something. In this case, this came directly from Lab Muffin Beauty Science. And if you haven't seen her, I'm gonna link in the description because she makes amazing videos. And she has a PhD in chemistry and is like a major skincare nerd. And we can actually listen to her. The thing is, with a DIY coming from a chemist, who says it's really easy, I don't know if it's really that easy. And so I kind of wanted to try it for myself. If it's easy enough where I can do it, no problems, and it's easy enough where you can do it. I actually usually use a vitamin C serum in my skincare routine, not the SkinCeuticals one. I used the Drunk Elephant one, but they recently changed the formula of the Drunk Elephant vitamin C serum because there was a lawsuit with SkinCeuticals. So anyway, they had to change the formula of it, and I'm not as crazy about it. And so I'm trying the Paula's Choice skin vitamin C serum, but it's not here yet. In the meantime, we're gonna try this little DIY vitamin C serum. If you don't know what vitamin C serum is good for, it has a lot of antioxidant, anti-aging properties, and one of the best things that it's great for is for hyperpigmentation. So for instance, if you have a breakout and it leaves like the little pink or red mark, the vitamin C helps fade that way faster. It's not exactly the same as the Drunk Elephant or the Paula's Choice or the SkinCeuticals serum, but this is still like a pure like vitamin C serum that you can still use to get a lot of the benefits for so much less. Let's just try this. So you're gonna need some vitamin C powder. I think it's also called vitamin C crystals. You're also gonna need some baking soda. Whoa. You don't shake it all over the place. Some pH strips, and you can get these on Amazon. Doesn't have to be these particular kind. You can get them for pretty cheap. You're also gonna need distilled water. Then you're also gonna need one of these little bottles. And you want one of these darker ones because it filters out UV light. She also says we're gonna need a little medicine measuring cup, which you probably already have in your medicine cabinet, as well as a quarter teaspoon measurer. I also have like a little scale that you'd use in your kitchen, but this should be all the things we need. She says we can also use this on different parts of our body, which is great because usually the stuff would be so expensive that you wouldn't want to waste it. So basically she says we want something that's between 5% and 20% L-ascorbic acid, which is basically another word for vitamin C. So we want between 5% to 20% this with a pH around 3.5, which is why we've got these guys here to measure what it is, and this baking soda to be the little balance between this. So we're gonna add some more baking soda until we hit that 3.5 amount. She also says we can cover one of these in aluminum foil or just a regular container in aluminum foil, and that blocks out the light too. So I might wind up getting some aluminum foil from out of my kitchen over there. So I guess she says the first thing we have to do is figure out how big our container is. So I gotta look that up. 2 ounces, basically 60 milliliters.
Next, you need to calculate how much L-ascorbic acid you need. You take the percentage you want, divide it by 100, then multiply it by the volume of the container.
One ounce is half of this, which is about also like 30-ish milliliters. So the Paula's Choice one that I'm ordering and I'm waiting patiently for it to arrive in the mail is 15%. So we're gonna go with that. So 15 divided by 100 is 0.15. times the volume, 30 is 4.5. Okay, we've got this set to zero, so it's not gonna measure the cup. We need 4.5 grams of this. I don't know why, but that was a very satisfying lid to open. There we go. I'm a little confused. See, the chemists, they know, and we commoners do not know. I'm a little confused how much water to put in. I think she's assuming we're gonna fill the thing up with water. So we were gonna do halfway, which is gonna be 1 ounce. So I need to get 1 fluid ounce of water. This thing is washed and alcoholed, and it's still a tiny little bit of water droplets on the inside. We're gonna put the powder in first. Already. We got some in there, and now we need to add 30 milliliters of water, this special water. Oh, chemists are good at pour. Okay, I'm too scared. This is going to take forever if I do it that way. I would suggest investing in a funnel if you're gonna do this very often. This is the fun part. I think it's thoroughly mixed. We need a little pH tester. I really enjoy this case. So we want it to be like 3.5, so somewhere in between. Let's see this. It's a pretty low pH. It definitely needs to be a little higher. It needs to be like 3.5. She says put just a tiny bit. We don't want to go too much, because then we got to do this all over again. Whoa, I hope that wasn't too much. I got a little aggressive there. That makes me nervous. I don't wanna do it again. Let's see what happens. It is a little lighter, so I actually might not have went too crazy. It still needs some more. She said this takes 5 minutes. Maybe for a chemist. I guess once you get the hang of it, maybe. See, this is why, like, so many DIY skin things, it's not worth it, because we're not testing the pH balance of it, but we should be, because you shouldn't be putting things that are too acidic or too alkaline on your skin. Yeah, I think this is fine.
This is fine.
Okay. Tin foil time to protect our new serum from the sunlight. I think I might have gotten too much. There we go, I think that's it. So we wanna test this out a little bit. I'm gonna test it out like on my face in my next video that you guys can watch, because I'm going to be doing another updated skincare routine video. And it literally just feels like water. Yay, we did it. I would say it's not that hard. And it's not so difficult that only a chemist can do it. Even a Sarah can do it. So you can too.
Remember, if Yen can cook, so can you, Jackie.
I've never made a serum before. This is so exciting. Anyways, I wanna hear from you guys in the comments. Have you ever used a vitamin C serum? I'll be using it in my next video, my updated skincare routine video, so you guys will wanna see that. So make sure you subscribe if you don't wanna miss out on any of those upcoming videos, and ring the little bell if you want those to come right to you. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you to Lab Muffin Beauty Science for making us all more educated. Anyways, I'll see you guys next time. Really pointy with the fingers today. It's like I'm conducting an orchestra over here or something. Measure twice, cut once. If you're cutting a piece of wood. I do remember one thing from like a chemistry class. You never like inhale, you always waft. See, I'm remembering my chemistry class. Oh, I was supposed to put half in. Oh, flibberty gibbets. Oh, toothpick.